thanks to you.
Instruction has been beneficial. A good option. It is a perfect day to exert oneself. Whatever. It is done.
In battle, it's necessary to deploy battalions so that students can experience taking command. I doubt I need to say this to a mercenary like you, but if you have any questions about how to use your soldiers, please don't hesitate to ask. After you hire a battalion, you'll need to decide who will lead them. Battalions can contain soldiers like mages and monks who don't fight with weapons. Be sure to think carefully about who would benefit most from the support of battalion soldiers and their specific skills. When you deploy a battalion, you can utilize its special gambit in battle. If a gambit is successful, your enemy will be severely shaken. Joining forces with a nearby ally is a surefire way to enhance your effectiveness.
As you wish.
Stay focused.
Battle.
will get the victory. I will prevail.
Put me in there.
That's my cue.
Hardly worth my time. Ed? I can fight through anything. Yeah.
was beneath me. Always getting...
so easily.
This is harder than expected.
Each battle, a chance to grow. Another step forward. Fought well.
honest.
It's dangerous.
Victory.
The battlefield has much to teach.
It's still rare to go.
What a jump.
A fine display.
My research had such results.
Any experience is worth having.
Our voices are all over the place. We must learn to work together in harmony.
Yeah! I'll sing so loud that my voice is gonna reach the sky!
It is done. Clear to me now. Enlightening. Not a total waste.
Let's put this to the test.
Hope this is good for something. One step before the next step.
Timing, Professor. I've just received word from the Knights. They've located the bandits.
It seems they have them cornered. They're in Xanadu, the Red Canyon.
I can't wait to get started. I'll strike down those heinous thieves before they know what hit them.
Charge ahead if you must, Caspar. Just do not put the rest of us in danger.
I'm going back. I won't be of any help anyway, and I don't want to get hurt. Don't worry, Byrne. It's just some bandits. We'll have no trouble at all.
Don't get ahead of yourselves. Unfounded optimism isn't a great strategy. Let's just get this over with.
There is nothing to get over. We will work with each other to achieve our mission.
It's time, Professor. Give us our orders and let's move out.
So, we are taking children into battle, are we? I'm not certain I will be able to sleep soundly after beholding something like that. I shall allow you to turn back the hands of time. But no, this power is not infinite.
So this is the Red Canyon, a ruin of sorts by the look of it. Let's end this quickly. The thieves must have been driven back. Be careful or the cornered mice might bite us.
The knights chased us all the way here?
Chief, let's get out of here. There's no way we can win against them.
Shut your dumb mouth! Where would we go at this point? You can't be a thief if you fear death!
Professor, I hear there's a back road to the west. Why don't we split up and attack from both the west and the front? If we advance tactfully, we can attack our enemy from both sides. I leave the rest to you. Regardless, we must cross the bridge first. I will prevail! Stay focused.
I am Ferdinand von Eyre.
Battle. As you wish.
That's my cue.
Put me in there.
I will get the victory. defeat was inevitable. Regrettable, but there was no other way.
It's time for a nicer.
Not quite what I was after. So, is making us experience a real battle part of the church's teachings?
This treasure, it's all ours. There's no way we're gonna give it up to some knights.
Let's stay careful. Greatness awaits me.
for success. People and beasts are as one. Calm your heart and do not be worried about this, Kimmy. Chance to grow. We'll do our part.
It all comes down to this.
That's my cue.
These ruffians are no match for a noble like me.
That's my cue. Myself. All roses have thorns.
From before? So what now? You're pals with the knights? I'll kill you and your pesky brats! down the knights means they've underestimated me. Listen to that idiot. What a mistake.
Thank you for leading us, Professor. Though I suppose there was no way we could lose to a familiar foe. In any case, something about this canyon feels inexplicably strange.
That you recall this place. You must be weak of heart. Each time I speak, it scares you so. Although the battle's at an end, do not feel too at ease. Well, anyhow, I am quite fascinated by this place. As far as I can tell, this is your first time here. How very odd. I wonder if somehow my memories have... I must admit I am unsure. Beyond the name and this strange feeling of familiarity, I can't seem to remember anything about this place. And yet... great depth of emotions tied to that sense of familiarity, like joy and sorrow, pain and love, and all things in between. If I was somehow here before, I wonder what took place.
Professor, I was wondering where you were. It's about time we headed back to the monastery.
It is time to depart. But know that time reveals all things. One day I will remember that which I have lost. Oh, by the way, it seems you've earned my gratitude. The thieves who came here are no more. I am not sure myself, yet I am grateful all the same. In any case, you must become accustomed to my voice. If you fall down with shock each time I speak, that just won't do. Oh, you think you're standing strong? Of course you are. It was a jest. On our way out, I had the chance to observe the Red Canyon. Did you notice anything, Professor? Of course. I expected as much. The area was covered in ruins, each more curious than the last. They did not match the architectural style of any era or culture within the Empire, or across all of Fothan for that matter. That can only mean one thing. The Valley civilization must have flourished and fallen in the distant past, long before the Empire was established. Who do you think lived there? It's possible they weren't even human. Perhaps their remnants still influence this world. So you have safely disposed of those bandits. But why did they target the students to begin with? We must further investigate the true cause of all that took place. Until we know more, I ask that you support the students and relieve them of any unnecessary worry. Good. I have high expectations for you. By the way, how is your time in Xanadu? Legend has it, in ancient times, a goddess alighted upon this world in that very canyon. Were a goddess from the heavens, Xanadu could only have been a temporary haven. Long ago, the divine Seiros received a revelation from the goddess, a gift to help guide the lost. The goddess is always watching over Fodlan from her kingdom above. However, in ancient times, the goddess graced this world with her presence and offered salvation to the people here. She is the mother of all life, the arbiter of everything. I see. During your time here, I pray that you come to devote yourself to the teachings of Seiros.
Lady Rhea, I am sorry to interrupt. There is something I must ask about in regard to those bandits.
As you wish. We shall continue our discussion when next we meet. A goddess? I have no memory of her. But then, I have no memory at all. Oh, how bothersome. It is as though I know, and yet I don't. Perhaps Xanadu was my home back when the goddess walked the land. If so, what does that make me now? A ghost? Are you simple? That's impossible. I am most certainly up. Of course, we also have the mystery of why I'm here with you. Is it somehow connected? Perhaps some past regret is stopping me from moving on, and now I'm forced to stay with you instead. No, that's not it. I can't believe in such a meaningless existence.
Part 1. White Clouds. Garland Moon. Mutiny in the Mist. When the warm winds blow from the sea to the south of Adrestia. Residents of Fodland know that the rainy season is upon them. Before the heavy rains take their toll, young women hurry to pick the last of the white roses. The ivory buds are woven into garlands and given as gifts to close friends or potential lovers.